Yep. Big fish too. Oh my God. Look at the size of him. Whoa. Come here, you. Look at the size of this bass. What? It's early summer and it's time to catch those big fat bass who have finished their spawn and all that kind of stuff. And now they're going to either offshore areas, moving off maybe those spawning areas, but there's always going to be a population of largemouth that inhabit shorelines. Whether the water's crystal clear or really murky, it doesn't matter. There's always some shoreline largemouth available. What we're gonna do today is show you how we do docks, grass, and wood, work between those docks, fish the high potential stuff with soft plastics, work topwaters, prop baits, etc. between, find all the little obscure spots between the high potential spots, and hopefully, by the end of the show, I'll get some big ones, and next time you go out, you'll get some even bigger ones by doing that shoreline approach, docks, rocks, and big old bass. Let's see if we can do it today. This thing, find those fish that maybe are roaming around. I call them rogue bass, between the stuff that is high potential. When I get to the good stuff, there's a whole bunch of options I have. Game hog, okay. Jig and chunk, you gotta always be ready right there. Couple other options, rodent. I see a fish come out, miss it and stuff. I got this rigged, an owner weighted hook. There's no sliding sink or nothing. It falls real slow. They see that, they come right back out again and eat it. That's what I'm trying to get across. Keep your eyes open. Look around, man. You want to fish the docks? Yes. Rocks and logs, etc. Submerged timber, little weed patches. But the stuff between, little things, an overhanging tree, some cedars, a tree in the water, maybe a little bit of an old crib, things that fish can relate to. Largemouth are notorious. Smallmouth, you get those rogue fish that just move around. Largies, they just love to hold, you know, and you get a little bit of sun like this. The morning was a little bit overcast. Now as the sun's high, those fish pull into tight stuff. You gotta put your baits in the highest potential areas where those fish use as ambush spots. You do that enough times, you're gonna catch your share a big largemouth in early summer along the shorelines. See the boat there? I worked that dock, followed some weed and some rock, came out here, a little bit of wood, and I'm going along the shoreline. There's not a lot here, there's just rocks and stuff. But if you look up here, boat, crib, and a dock, high potential area. So I'll probably work along this stuff pretty quickly. Go along here, maybe throw a buzz bait or make longer pitches. Keep your bait, you know, game hog, rodent, jig, whatever it is you're using, worm, keep it in the water. But when you get the high potential stuff like that boat dock, pick up your confidence bait, pitch it in to your high potential spots, some darkness close to the cover, chances are you're gonna get a big fish. So we're gonna keep working along with this here. I'll make longer pitches before I get to the high potential stuff, but I'm not gonna make a real long pitch far away from that stuff. I'll get as close as I can where I feel I'm comfortable that I can set hook. I'm using 20 pound fluoro. It's got low stretch, but again, I don't want those fish to see anything, just that little game hog there. And I'm gonna keep pitching along, get close to it, make a few pitches, hopefully catch a big fish. So that's it. On docks, look, whoa. Look at the size of this pig. Hey, look at him, on docks, on shorelines. Get over here. Where are you going, boy, huh? There he comes, look at that. See what I mean? When you fish a docks right, let's pull it out here. That's what you can get. Look where he's got that too, hey? That owner finds their mark, and when they're big, they're big. Look at the size of him. Now that's what I'm saying. Going along early morning docks, boats, cribs, soft plastics, and you can get them like this. We're gonna keep doing it, show you how we do it, how you can do it, and put guys like this in the live well, take some pictures and let them go. Good, nice big fish, eh? That's one heck of a good bass. Let's put him in there. I love you big girls. Going in there, go for a swim. And now, That's what I'm talking about, see? Fishing, high potential areas, you slow down. I mixed up the trolling motor, I turn it up between spots, throw a buzz bait, throw a popper, maybe a walking dog kind of bait. Cover those areas between the docks. You see a weed patch, see grass, see rock, whatever it is, hit those high potential spots. You come to docks with a little bit of sloping shorelines. Slow down, soft plastics, they don't let it go. I mean, look at that piggy, hey? Ready you? Go on you. Have a look in the live well, what these fish are eating and regurgitating. That's one of those big bass, rock bass. You think a bait's too big? Not for largemouth. Well, here we are in the California Delta with the man who makes these frogs. And buddy, you've seen it on Xtreme Angler. I love to use these frogs and it's an honor, seriously, to be fishing with the guy who snag-proof designed these frogs on his input, Bobby Barrick. Well, Bobby, I'm pretty excited, man. We saw some stripers this morning, my first California Delta largemouth.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. We were just talking about the open water thing, you know. We fish our frogs in open water a lot, you know. We tried the striper thing for the first 10 minutes. Now we're going to walk our frogs in the outside of this matted vegetation.
Okay.
Not the real thick stuff, and we kind of touched on that. We're going to fish a stringy grass that's on the bottom that kind of comes up and then flumes.
Gotcha.
So they can actually sit underneath these canopies and they can see 360 degrees. So that's the kind of stuff that we're going to target the rest of the day.
Right on. And we're going to fish back and forth based on the tides and stuff?
Yep.
For fish position and stuff like that? Okay, we'll do that.
You know, one of the biggest mistakes, Carl, when I'm guiding and some of my clients that aren't real accustomed to throwing frogs, they're new at it, when they lose big ones, what they do is they set the hook and they'll rotate their hips and they'll get the rod behind their shoulders.
Okay.
And that fish will run this way and you lose the bow in your rod. You lose hook point pressure and that fish comes off. So
gotcha.
If guys stay squared up, throw your frog out here, stay squared up, stay in a perpendicular line to your bait, pop, pop, pop. You get the bite, 7 to 12, right there, and you're good. And just wind, rotate a little bit, but keep your rod right in front of your shoulders, and most of those big fish will stay pegged.
Gotcha. Nice if you can pull them off the grass and follow it and hit it in open water, eh?
Yeah. Sometimes they'll do that. Not a lot.
No.
Sometimes you'll get a lot of bites on the edges, just like what you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
And I think what it is you get the attention of that fish way back in that heavy cover, and she just kind of stays behind it, and then it breaks free and she bolts out there and grabs it before it gets away.
Gotcha. Oh, there you go, big fish, Carl. Big fish.
Wow.
Big fish, bud.
Wow.
Big fish.
Look at the size of this thing. This Delta.
Let me reel her in.
It's scary, man.
Let me reel her in.
Oh, cow. Where are you, big boy? Big sow. Look at this.
I'll land her for you.
Oh, look at this. Oh, wow.
Come here, sweetie.
Delta. Oh, my goodness. Look at that. I'm at Delta, man. I am ecstatic. I can't tell you what it's like. Seriously, Bobby, this is not stroking your ego, mind, but a long time watching you do your
good
stuff.
Good placement on the hooks there, bud.
You get a chance to fish with this guy. Look at that. This is going to join the other one in the live well.
Okay.
I think we're going to upgrade today from these.
Yeah. Let's do this.
All right, folks. On the Delta, man.
California
man
Delta
himself.
Frog fishing, baby.
As good as it gets, eh?
With Xtreme Angler
wow.
Television. I like
wow.
it.
Look at that mess, hey? That's what you see on the Delta. Wow. World-class largemouth bass fishing, man. Look at that pig. Wow. Last but not least, that's to a very successful day with the frog, snag-proof on the Delta with Bobby Barrick. Wow. A day I will not forget for a long time. Look at that. Letting pigs loose. All right, another week on the water. Early September, you know, we get emails all the time and questions from people at trade shows and what you do once September comes. You know what? And I'm fishing for largemouth and smallmouth. I'm doing almost exact same things, looking for big fish. But in this case, I'm going to fish on shorelines a little bit steeper or heavier cover. I don't get out too early in the morning. It's about 9 o'clock now, and I don't find a big use unless I want to fish some top water. But you know what? For me, that's a real good summer pattern. And sure, it works in early fall, but this is the time where those big fish want to bear up. What I mean by that is they want to put on the bulk, eat big baits, eat heavy, eat often. So I'm going to show you today, hopefully, what I can do to put more fish in the boat to show you on a lake that's got both largemouth and smallmouth with jigs, rodents, craws, stickworms, the whole deal. But I'm going to show you some different locations possibly to find those fish. See if we can do it. So it's rocks. Again, the shoreline's, well, 5.5 feet deep with scattered grass. That's all you need sometimes. I'm telling you, big fish can just cruise the shorelines, and that's what big fish do. They're like wolves. They go along. Don't think you need to find a whole school of fish. You don't have to, man. Especially if you're fishing for big fish. You're looking for those isolated fish. Sometimes they're 2 pounds, sometimes they're five. The odd time, they're that scary size, those sevens. And they're like a big wolf, just cruising the shoreline. It's using big baits with big rattles, big rods, heavy stuff, looking for big fish. Put my bait in some heavy cover. And since it's September, there's a lot less boat traffic. So what that means is, sometimes these fish can get set up good and they can stay there. And that's fantastic for an angler like myself, who likes to fish heavy cover, docks and rocks and logs, etc. Those fish can set up, they don't get spooked off, and hopefully they'll stay there for the whole day. Before they move around, we can catch them. Let's see. I'm gonna tell you something real quick. It's called junk spots. They look like junk. And most guys go to the high potential stuff. They see other bass boats or fishing boats. Sometimes look for the junk spots, junky shorelines, because I guarantee you, bass can find the most obsolete nook and cranny little spots. If you can find those spots away from the public hot holes, or you know, the crowded spots, you'll catch fish other guys don't catch by looking for those junk shorelines, junky looking spots. Use a bait like the jig, worm, rodent, craw, different things that you can put in right in those tight little spots where those bass rarely see a bait. And I tell you, man, you do that enough times, you're gonna find some of those bigger fish on the lakes you fish. If he doesn't see my jig, he can hear the rattles. That's why I go with rattles. Sometimes if they don't see it, they can hear it. And that's all they need to do is hear it. And then it's game on. Rock right here. Wow. Here comes another dock. This dock's a little high off the water, but you know what? Never say never, man. Because I tell you, sometimes when you think not, it's got the fish that'll be the ear. Look at the size of him. Oh my God. Oh boy. A long pitch. Oh boy. The size of this bass. Oh. Oh, look at that. That's what I mean. Far pitch. Under the dock. Deep docks, man. Get out in September. Get out there, I'm telling you. Don't even consider putting the rods away. Look where I got them. And that's because of the spider thread. I pitched really far. There's grass underneath there. And that fish just came out, doom, swimming. And see how far away I was? I'm telling you, you cannot set hard enough. Some guys talk about rocking the boat. I rock the boat, and that's why I do it. Because there's monsters like this out there waiting for you on those public lakes. Look where we are. Look at this. Sailboats. And almost got it all to myself. We'll put him in the live well and take some pictures of these fish and let them go. Okay, my friend, you fought nice. I like getting them sometimes from a distance away. Look at that. See, sometimes it's fun. For TV, it's great getting them far away. But I'm telling you, it is. Your heart goes like crazy in tournaments, or especially when you need those fish in the boat in competition. You want to be as close as you can making those pitches. I made a far pitch out there. Look at that dock, it's really nothing. It's off the water, but it's got some supports and it's got grass underneath. That's what the fish went to. I'm gonna keep going. I'm gonna find some trees. maybe some slop edges, boat houses, everything a little bit farther out. The sun does come up, it's supposed to get nice and hot today. I'm gonna get in a little bit tighter, maybe fish some pads and stuff too. We'll see if we can get some more. That's a good start to the morning. Fishing in early September. Big largies, man. Boy, boy. Let's see if we can hopefully pop a couple more like that somewhere today. Hey, welcome back to Xtreme Angler. This week, wouldn't you know it? Sarcastic, eh? Fishing wood, submerged timber. Sometimes it's gonna be trees in the water, stumps, and like I was just fishing a beaver dam. But it's late August and the water's cooling and stuff, but that really has no bearing on these largemouth. They're in positions where they should be. They're in docks, trees, you name it. They're in all the spots we like to fish for largies. That's near structure and cover. But today, it's about submerged timber. It's timber time for big, fat largemouth. I'm hoping I'm gonna get some big ones, but it's all about perseverance and fishing in the moment. Let the fish tell me what they want. It's a smaller profile, a little 5/16, 3/16 and 1/4 tungsten sinkers. I'm gonna be fishing little pockets, little edges, different things. Wherever there's wood in the water, I'm gonna put this little bait. Let it sink, shake it, move it, drag it, whatever it takes to get those fish to hopefully bite it. So let's keep going. Let's find some logs, and you can use the same things you see here today on Xtreme Angler on your favorite body of water and catch those big fat hogs sitting on the wood. Let's go. Man, look at all this wood and stuff. When I make those pitches, it goes out, I hold the rod high. I'm not worried about setting hook right away. I'll reel in that slack line and set. But I'm watching the line going down, settling in that deeper 6, 7, 10 feet of water, then shaking it, then reeling up the slack, and then shaking. Nothing, bring it in, same thing. Cast out, I can feel, by the rod being high, I'm watching the line go down. Bring it in the slack. When I feel bottom, shake it a bit. I can detect a lot more bites with that spongy weight or the pickups. It's incredible, even with these really good St. Croix rods, you can't feel that bite up sometimes. It's just, they just eat it. These baits look so real. You know, it's nature, man. These things, little craws like that, little DB craw, when they see it, it's done. Come on, fish. I'm gonna find these isolated stumps out here on these flats. And they're not really stumps, it's big logs and trees. And you wonder how they get out here. It's because they fall. In wintertime, they come down and they fall on the ice. And as the ice pulls out, melts, well, it pulls those logs out with them, right there. That's one of those logs right there. I don't know if there's a fish on it. A lot of times when you find those logs out here in this deep stuff, on a big old flat, there's nothing else for those fish to hold to. They'll hold to those big stumps and trees. When the water's tea color like this, I want a little bit of metal flake or contrast with a natural tone. And what I mean is I want the fish to see the bait, but again, have some natural tone like the green pumpkin with the orange. We all know crayfish have a lot of orange, especially up north in northern Ontario. So it has that natural hue, but I just want them really to see it. You know, because I'm putting it in locations where those fish are. They're on those logs, they see it. If they're there, they're gonna take a shot at it. But adding a little bit of that natural hue, you know, the green pumpkin, you can't beat it. Summer craw is another good option, but I like it because it has the chartreuse real bright when the water is really dingy or it's really wavy, or if it's got some mud action to it, stuff where you're fishing in front of creeks and stuff, and it has more off color, like a muddy tone. For me, that'd be the choice, a summer craw. And black with blue fleck, you can't go wrong. You know what? Everybody uses black and blue. It still works. The reason why they use it, because it catches, but I like using things with green and sometimes that orangey brown. Last but not least, one of my choices for here would be that watermelon with red and black flake. You can't go wrong. Again, natural green. All bait fish have green in them. You add a little bit of red flake, just adds that maybe that triggering effect. Fish see it, they're going to eat it. Oh, it's a huge beaver dam. Comes way out here. Holy moly. Bass could be anywhere here. Anywhere, like out here. Holy moly. That's a huge beaver hole. Come here. Whoa. Whoa. Look at this thing fight, hey? You know why? Because he's big and bad. Oh, where did you get it? He just on the side of the face? Oh, oh no. Come here. Come here. I can't lift you in. Oh, but I can grab you in. That's the ones right there, dudes. When you're fishing beaver dams and stuff, look at the belly on that fish. You think he's eating? Because all kinds of rock bass and nasty stuff go in there. And that's what goes in there too. Big, beautiful, largemouth bass. Look how black their back is. They can hide in that tannic water. They fight like beasts, as you can tell. The wood, don't give up on it, man. Seriously, let's put her in a box. We'll take some pictures. She's got more girth, look at that, seriously, than her length, I bet you. You've been eating good, huh? We'll let you go after, don't worry, big girl. Oh, Lordy. Let's put her in here with her friend. Look at that. Now that's a big, fat bass. But look at that belly. Isn't that impressive? Whew. Let's put her in there. Turn on the pumps. I tell you, you talk about exciting, man. You know, you find these beaver dams, and what you do is waypoints, make waypoints. Because you're going up a lake and you're focused on where you're driving. You got to be aware of rocks and all that kind of stuff, people, swimming, boaters. And sometimes you miss those little sticks, small beaver dam. But in this case, it must be a big beaver because it comes all the way out here. And I fished, all of a sudden just feel that familiar sensation. That's all it is. No bite, sensation. Whack! You know what happens then? The world turns off. It's just you and that fish. Good line. Thank you, Gemma. And them rods, sensitivity. Strong. St. Croix, I tell you, man, they make the best rods on earth. That is their tagline, and you've seen why. You can feel those fish. You hit them, and it's got the strength so you can put them in the boat, a few pictures, and let them go. This week, it's early season, bass season. That's an oxymoron. Anyhow, we're going to be fishing everything shallow. Shallow water, largemouth, smash, bash, crash, you name it. Different baits, jigs, rodents, game hogs, maybe even big flip tubes. Everything shallow. It's only been 3 or 4 days since bass opener, so those fish are going to be close to where they spawn, shallow water, unpressured, and hopefully they'll come out to play. So we're going to put all the things we know to catch those shallow water bass, hopefully some big bass, on soft plastics, jigs. Let's do it. See, like working this stuff right here? Look at that. Trees, pad with arrowhead. Put it up. Do not take your eyes off it. Keep the trolling motor going. Angle it, turn out. Make your pitches. Dissect that. The outside, the inside. And just hop it. Let that bait fall. There's a stick up here too. When wind comes down like this, I'm working against it. So I'm gonna dissect these little spots. The tree, look at that. I see one log up here sticking up. Working around, looking around. Here's a log right here. Big pop in here. Look at this stuff right here. Rock bass there. Look at this tree. You think, oh, maybe too shallow? Never, man. The bass is back. It's covered with water. Largemouth especially, he could be in there. It is never too shallow. My boat can float. Guess what? I'm fishing for bass, largemouth. I'll put that bait in there, take my time. Look at this tree. Look how dark it is underneath there. Dissect this little area and you find those big ones. Wow, man. Look at this, another tree coming down right here. Dock, just dissecting the shoreline, man. Looking for those big fish that are just looking for an easy meal. 18 inches of water to maybe 2 feet, 3 feet the most today. That's all I'm doing today. All the shallow stuff. Have some fun. Catching big old hogs. There's a little pad right in front here. You always make a picture of this kind of stuff. You think you can see the bottom? They find the hot spot. They find the dark shadow or the little hole that you won't see until you get too close, like right there. Here comes the pitch, my friend. I see a small weed patch up here. Anything on a weed patch? Yep, big fish too. Oh my God. Oh. Look at the size of him. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Come here, you. Look at the size of this bass. Oh, cow. Where's he got it? Look out, he's gonna come coming in the boat in a second. Oh, look at that. Hey, look at the size of this piggy. Holy cow, eh? Ho, ho, ho. That's what I mean. You do them shorelines and you can find them giant hogs just like this on your lakes. Look at him. Let's get out of this windy spot. Sometimes they say go to the shallow side, the non-windy side. This is what's on the windy side. And you know what? The wind helps. You know why? They're not as weary. That thing comes down, that little hog bait shook. He's seen it. Look at him. Look at. We're gonna put him in the live well, take some pictures, and we're gonna be back after a few words from our sponsors. Stick around on Xtreme Angler, because there's a good chance we're gonna get more of these after the break. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. And remember, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Facebook and Instagram, and we'll see you next time.